Amen.
At this time, we had Brother David Bishop. Will you come and read the scripture? Amen. And after that, we have a selection. We have a selection. Then we will have a Reverend Miles take us through the sonogram.
Huh? Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Yeah.
The scripture is going to be coming from the book of St. John, chapter 4, verses 5 through 15. Again, that's the book of St. John, chapter 4, verses 5 through 15. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
And it reads, so he came to a city, to the city of Samaria, which is called Shechem, near the plot of ground that Jacob gave to his son Joseph. Now Jacob's well was there. Jesus, therefore being weary from the journey, sat thus by the well. It was about the sixth hour. A woman from Samaria came to draw water. Jesus said to her, give me a drink. For his disciples had gone away from the city to buy food. Then the woman of Samaria said to him, how is it that you, being a Jew, ask to drink of me, a Samaritan woman? But Jews have no dealings with the Samaritans. Jesus answered and said to her, if you knew the gift of God and who it is who says to you, give me a drink, you would have asked him, and he would have given you living water. The woman said to him, sir, you have nothing to draw with, and the well is deep. Where then do you get this living water? Are you greater than our father Jacob, who gave us the well and drank from it himself, as well as his sons and his livestock? Jesus answered and said to her, whoever drinks of this water will thirst again. But whoever drinks of the water that I shall give him will never thirst. But the water that I shall give him will become in him a fountain of water springing up to everlasting life. The woman said to him, sir, give me this water that I may not thirst, nor come here to draw again. And the Lord had a blessing for the reading of his word.
He's getting ready for it.
Oh,
Amen.
Praise the Lord. All the time.
Praise the Lord.
Eternal and all right, Father God, give us this eyes, look to go, be good for us. Woke us up this morning, start us going over.
Yes.
We're so happy to be in this service.
Yes.
One more time.
One more time.
We thank you, Father, for all that you do for us, for yes. provide for us, realize that all our help comes from you.
Yes.
You say you sit high and you look for them, you know all about it.
Yes.
You know what we need better than we do ourselves.
Yes.
If you give us what we need, not according to our greed, but according to our
yes.
And we thank you.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you.
But we realize we just passed through this earth.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. This earth is not our home. We just built it, passing through.
Yes.
But we thank you because you're helping us control
yes,
through.
Yes. Yes.
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. Yes. And we're so thankful.
Yes, Lord.
And we pray for all the sick and needy to shut in. We pray for everybody that wants to be here if we could.
Yes, Lord.
And we're thankful for the ones who did show up tonight.
Thank you, Jesus.
Pray that you'll bless us with a kind word from the speaker tonight.
Yes, Lord.
And help us, my Father, to live on in your word.
Yes.
We realize the best is yet.
Yes, Lord.
Trouble don't last always.
Yes.
He said there's a bright side somewhere.
Yes.
And we can't wait till we get there.
Right.
While we're going through the Bible, we have questions for sick, we even want to shut in. And we just thank you for all that you have done. Pray that you continue to help us go home safe and sound as we came.
Yes, Lord. Yes,
Lord. Bless this church.
Yes, Lord.
Bless Pastor.
Yes, Lord.
And his wife.
Bless him.
We're doing such a good job.
Yes, Lord.
A mighty good job to you today, your sister. And I pray for my Father that you continue to bless them.
Yes, Lord.
That you may have not only many more servants, but to bless their lives.
Yes, Lord.
That's all blessed in Jesus' holy name. Now come, Father, right now. Let everyone understand my voice. Pick us up the way that you would have us to go.
Yes.
Help us to feed on your word tonight.
Yes.
That we may not go home the way we came, but go with more power and more strength than Jesus.
Yes.
Our soul says, amen.
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 Amen. Amen. Amen.
I made over.
God, he made it over. It was Jesus.
Hallelujah.
It was Jesus. We don't have to second guess. It was Jesus. Yeah. Amen. Do you have anything to be thankful for?
Amen.
Everything.
Everything.
As we breathe, just thank you, Jesus. The eyes we looking at, thank you, Jesus.
Thank
the feet that we walk, thank you, Jesus.
Yes.
As we breathe, thank you, Jesus.
Yes.
Thank you for life and all life blessings. Amen. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Thank God for Reverend Towns. Of reading the scripture, Brother David Bishop, vice versa, praying and reading the scripture. Amen. Praise the Lord.
We are at this time.
At this particular time, we are blessed. It's not but a chain reaction from what we done down Baltimore last Sunday. We had a good time in the Lord. Amen. We're going to carry this spirit right on down with us. To today, we thank God for the preacher of the hour today. Amen. We were down Baltimore together. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Amen. But I have the honor and pleasure of let someone know him better than I know him. Amen. And so we'd like to have his wife. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Sister Mills, we're coming to introduce the preacher. Amen. The preacher for the hour. Amen.
Amen.
And there'll be another selection. And after that, that'll be the preacher. Amen.
No.
Praise the Lord.
No.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise
the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord. Amen.
Ooh, I had the great honor and privilege to introduce the preacher of the hour, my husband, Reverend Mills. I'm not going to talk about the husband part because I was asked to introduce the preacher.
That's right. That's right.
So I just ask that you will sit back and let your don't sit back and do nothing. Let the spirit move you.
That's right. Amen.
He's got a word. God has given him a word. I don't know what his word is, but I know God has given him a word.
Amen.
I'm not going to go through all the schooling and all that, Sister Burton and Sister Burton always say, but God is head of his life.
Amen.
He's a student of the word.
Amen.
He often get lost in the word, you know.
Amen.
You know, so I thank God for that.
Amen.
Because I know Michael.
Yes.
Before I knew Reverend Mills.
Amen.
So there's no secret what God can do, right?
That's
he came for him. He did for all of us, amen.
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 Amen. So with no further words, the next voice you will hear will be that of Reverend Michael Mills of Honeycomb Church in Lima, Pennsylvania.
Amen. 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 Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
No, but you will still get it.
Yeah, what is his name?
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Anyhow.
Mm-hmm.
Yes,
mm-hmm.
Lord. Thank you, precious.
You are the living word. 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 Praise the Lord.
Jesus. That's what I call manger born.
That's right.
Hung on a tree.
Yes.
He died to save humanity. Jesus.
Yes.
You know, when you can't get nothing else out of your mouth, you should be able to get Jesus out of your mouth. Oh, what you talking about, preacher?
Yes.
It wasn't that long ago, I couldn't call on nobody.
Nobody.
I couldn't even call on my wife.
My Lord.
COVID-19 had grabbed a hold of me. We had a high time in Atlantic City at the 2nd, 3rd, and 5th Episcopal District Conference. And I got home that Monday night, and I'm like, I got a sore throat.
You got
up Tuesday, took a test.
Yeah.
COVID.
My goodness.
I said, okay, Lord. That thing, Reverend, had me on my back. I couldn't call on nobody. I couldn't call you. I couldn't call Bishop. I couldn't call Mike down in Baltimore.
All
I could call on was Jesus.
I said, Jesus.
Lord, I need you. I need you right now.
Right now. Praise the Lord.
I thank God that when the physical body get weak, the spirit man can stand tall. I thank God that we're triune beings.
Amen.
You know, we live in the flesh.
That's right.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. But this flesh ain't our own.
No.
That's a temporary dwelling place.
Yeah.
Temporary dwelling place. I thank God for the brother, my brother.
Amen.
Amen. And thank God for you. I pray that God will continue to keep you and your family during your time of bereavement, you know.
Yes, right.
Bereavement don't have no time limit.
No.
You ain't got no time
limit.
I was messing around last week and said, call my pop. Pop been dead.
My Lord.
So, you know, you start feeling, you start missing.
Yeah.
So, bereavement, we need to always pray for those who are still dealing with bereavement.
Yes, that's right.
Still dealing with what? I don't care how old it is or how fresh it is.
Yes, that's right.
Or how fresh it is.
Yeah.
They all stand in the need of prayer. First, giving honor and glory to God the Father, God Elohim, God who spoke. And things just begin to happen. Let there be light.
That's right. That's right.
Yes. Amen.
And it was. And for Jesus, who is the Christ, my Lord and my Savior.
Yeah,
you know, we had an interesting Bible study last month or so when we were talking about can Jesus be your Savior and not your Lord?
Mm-hmm.
There's a lot of saved folk.
Amen.
In the church. You got to be careful what we say.
That's right.
Amen. Amen.
Right. But is he your Lord? Because
mm-hmm.
if he's your Lord, he has full control of your life.
That's
you
right.
got no say.
That's right.
Whatsoever.
Right.
Amen.
That's right. You got no say. So we got to be mindful. We're responsible for everything we speak. He is my Lord and my Savior. Amen. I may not always do what he tells me to do, but praise be to God that he left us those 66 books with examples of King David, who was when he stumbled and fell, he cried out, Lord, forgive me.
That's right. Right.
Against thee and thee alone have I sinned.
That's right. There you go.
You know.
Said so.
Woo.
Ooh, yes.
Donnie McClurkin said, we fall down. But we get back up.
My Lord.
So I thank God for Jesus.
Amen.
That we're under grace.
Amen.
That we're under grace, living in the dispensation of grace. And for the Holy Spirit, woo, when we started saying, Jesus, did you feel the breeze come through? Did you feel the Holy Spirit start to breathe on you? I was sitting there and I almost shouted. I said, woo. Thank you, Holy Spirit. You know, I thank God for the Holy Spirit that empowers us.
Amen. That's right.
Do what we need to do.
Amen.
And who also rebukes us when we need to be rebuked.
That's right.
You know, that's
right.
Why we should always have a heart sensitive to the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Sensitive to the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
To my brother, Reverend Burton here.
Yes.
God bless you, son.
Yes.
to his lovely wife, and to St. Luke, all the officers and members of St. Luke, who continue to let this old crazy boy from the country come over here. You know, they allow me to come over here and be whom God's called me to be.
Amen.
You know, I was wild in the streets. You could be on a Friday night, I'll be just, you know, getting everything right.
Getting
that outfit right.
Outfit
right. You know what I'm talking about. Somebody in here know what I'm talking about.
Amen.
You know, getting ready.
Yeah.
You know. But praise be to God that I got the outfit right to get ready.
That's right. That's right. That's right.
To get ready to come to Westchester. I thank God for that. You know, all of you who come out tonight, God bless you. Thank you for coming out. I promise not to be before you very long. I see, I ain't got no mask on. So. See, when I'm at church, I can say that and they don't know I'm smiling. But I promise not to keep you too long. I thank God for all of you coming out. My co-workers, Louise, Sister Townsend, you know, we got something done down there.
Amen.
Woo! Boy, we out of time. Jermaine get singing. We get a slinging. But I thank God for them, Reverend Townsend, for coming out. Any other ministers of the gospel in the house? I want to recognize you this evening. Any other? All right, man.
Amen.
Any disciples of Christ in the house?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. I want to see who's listening.
All right.
I like to keep you on the toes. I want to know who's listening. You know. Amen. But I thank God for all of you, for my church, Honeycomb, for allowing me the latitude and the freedom to just to be who I am.
Amen.
I thank God for Honeycomb. And for my pastor, Stuart, who's
amen.
Here.
Yes, amen.
God bless you. Thank you.
Amen.
Thank you.
Amen.
And for my ride or die. See, God saved us the same time.
Amen.
At doing the same service.
Amen.
You know, we was hard charges.
Yeah.
God said, I need some rough riders. I need some rough riders. You know, I took church clothes. We went home. I took church clothes home because that's what you do.
Yeah.
You go to church on Sunday. I ain't know that I had an appointment. I ain't know that God had an appointment that I was going to get saved. I didn't even know she was on the other side of the church getting saved.
Until
he brought us together. God, he called us the same day out of darkness into His marvelous life.
Amen.
And that she was my rough rider in the streets. Amen. You know, because I used to hang out in the clubs. She used to get put out of the club. She used to get barred. Name on the board. 30 days. She said, I know you ain't going back up there. Ain't got nothing to do with me. I used to DJ. I said, I'm going to make that money. I guess I'll see you when I get home. She come up there and sit outside. I don't know. They didn't know I'm a rat.
They need to know.
But she was a hard charge. We was rough out there. And I thank God that we're rough on this side.
All right.
And I used to tell them I went straight, no chasing.
No chasing. Perfect.
And that's what I endeavor to do, is to preach the gospel straight.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. No chasing.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
No fillers.
Amen.
And get in where you fit in. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. So I thank God for that. You heard the reading of the word. Very familiar passage of scripture out of the gospel of John, fourth chapter, read verses 1 through 15. I'm just going to pick up and read a portion of that. I ain't going to read but one verse. Amen. Jesus answered and said to her, if you knew the gift of God and who it is who says to you, give me a drink, you would have asked him and he would have given you living water.
Living water.
Living water.
Amen.
Let us pray. All wise and eternal God, we thank you. We thank you for right now. And I thank you for just yet another opportunity to stand and proclaim your word. I decrease that you may increase. Hide the man, Michael, behind the shadow of Jesus' cross, so that the words of his mouth and the meditation of his heart, they will be acceptable in your sight. You are his strength and his redeemer. Amen.
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 Jesus said to her, if you knew the gift of God and who it is who says to you, give me a drink, you would have asked him and he would have given you living water.
Living
water.
Amen.
And for a thought this evening, I'm just going to keep it brief. Thirsty for living water.
Amen.
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 Thirsty for living water. Thank you, Holy Ghost.
Yes.
Because this world is thirsty.
Yes.
This world is thirsty. But it's thirsty for the living water.
So
we are living in a dry and thirsty world that is trying to quench its thirst from Jacob's well. Ooh, help me, Holy Ghost. We are living in a dry and thirsty world that is trying to quench its thirst from Jacob's well. This world is thirsty, and the devil has them believing that it's okay. Woo! Because you can always get a drink from Jacob's way. I stand before you and say that he's a liar and the truth is not in him. He's a liar and the truth is not in him. That's why there's so much chaos in the streets of our community today. That's why we have babies killing one another and their elders with no remorse. They do so as easily, Pastor, as we swallow flies in our house. That's why our elected officials in America are making decisions based on what's good for them. And not what's best for the people. Why atrocities are occurring all around the world today, notwithstanding the war in Ukraine. We have genocides in Myanmar, in South Sudan, and in Central Africa. There's a Republican war between the Christians and the Muslims. Chaos all over the world.
Amen.
This world is thirsty.
Amen.
And the devil has them believing that it's okay because when you get thirsty, you can just go get a drink from Jacob's well. The Urban Dictionary says that being thirsty is being desperate or overly eager for something, which leads to explicit and unusual behavior to try and quench that thirst.
Thirst.
Some of our senior citizens, I can get that discount. Thirsty means, to the young folk, that means I'm thirsty for you.
Okay.
Amen. Well, girls, I'm thirsty for you. And you say that to some of the babies my age, they want to know, well, I can go buy you a bottle of water. I can buy you a bottle of water, you know, but when you're thirsty for something, you do all your unusual things. Nothing will stop you from trying to quench that thirst. This world is thirsty, but it's drinking from the wrong way. It's drinking from the wrong way. However, if I may be so bold as to say that this world and our elected officials, even our young people who are drinking from Jacob's well, it's not entirely their fault, Pastor.
My Lord, help.
What you talking about, preacher? It ain't entirely their fault. Yes, everybody is responsible for their own action, and there are consequences for their action. The fact remains, they may be drinking from Jacob's well because it's the only well that they know
about. Amen.
Woo!
Amen.
Right.
Amen.
Right.
Amen.
Right. That's all they know.
That's it.
I was talking with a brother of mine, Reverend Cooper, one day. We was talking. We said, we need to stop saying that they know better, that she should know better, that he should know better. They don't know better. All they know is what they're getting taught in the streets. We got two and three generations of unchurched folks in the streets, and the church is set back saying they ought to know better. I know my generation ought to know better because them elders in the community told you, boy, you better straighten up. You should know better because I know your parents. I know how you've been raised.
That's right.
We don't know how these kids are being raised.
That's right. Come on, preacher. Come on, preacher.
Stop wagging our finger at him saying he should know better. He knows. He's doing what he knows.
Amen. Amen.
All that he knows. We've got to be go and tell them that there is another way.
Amen. Yes. Amen.
There's another way, brother. And you don't have to pick up a gun.
That's right.
There's another way, sister.
Amen.
You don't have to demean yourself for attention.
Amen.
You don't have to do it.
That's right.
Woo!
Amen.
That's right.
Amen.
That's right, man.
You don't have to do it. They're drinking from Jacob's well because it's the only well they know.
That's right.
You see, the woman here in our text went to draw water from the only viable well she knew of.
Amen. Amen.
She didn't go when the other ones went.
Mm-hmm.
But that's a whole nother sermon.
Amen. Amen.
She wasn't at the highest point of the day.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
When holy wasn't nobody around because, you know, mm-hmm. I'd be like, we don't want nobody to, you know, we don't want to offend nobody.
Amen. Mm-hmm. Amen.
You know, with our lifestyle. Jesus instructs us, his disciples, to go, therefore, and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all things that I have commanded you. We have got to go fulfill the Great Commission. Tell somebody about Jesus, the race of Christ. Tell them they got a soul to save and a God to glorify. Let them know that you don't have to keep drawing from Jacob's well. Woo! I can lead you to a man that will give you water that will spring up in you. And you'll be watering other people.
That's right. That's right.
And you'll be watering other people.
Amen.
Woo! Our text said he left Judea and departed again to Galilee. But he needed to go to Samaria.
My Lord.
There's a version out there that said that he had a need to go.
A need to go. Amen.
Samaria. Jesus needed to go through Samaria to the church, which are made up of his disciples.
Yes, yes.
Had a need to go through Samaria.
Yes, sir. Mm-hmm. Amen.
You gonna find out? Organize the street or walk through.
That's right. That's right.
And you'll see. As I told the bishop the other day, we'll find out what trouble brings to you. He said, find out what he's working. You'll find out who has a need to go through Samaria. How would this world know about the living water Jesus Christ has to offer? If we don't go and tell them about Jesus.
That's right.
In this fourth chapter of the Gospel of John, verses 1 through 42, you can read it in its entirety, this woman's encounter with Jesus and subsequently what transpired after she encountered Jesus.
My Lord.
This world and all who are thirsty is in need of an encounter with Jesus. Of an encounter with Jesus. I'm not talking about a, hey, how you doing? I'm talking about a spiritual encounter with the one who can quench their thirst. A spiritual encounter which will take place if this world is to change. That's what's needed.
Amen. Amen, preacher.
Amen.
Amen.
We can lobby the senators.
Yes, sir.
We can do all the marching.
That's right.
We can do all the protesting we want.
Yeah.
But if those men on Capitol Hill ain't had a spiritual encounter with Jesus, who is the Christ, their behavior will never change. I don't care whether they're Republicans or Democrats.
That's right.
They're all the same. I say get rid of the whole lot.
That's it.
And start fresh.
Amen.
Start fresh.
Amen.
Because we just recycling.
Yes.
The same people almost in this. Thank you, Holy Ghost. We were just recycling. If this world has a real encounter with Jesus, things would change.
Mm-hmm.
Things would change. If there is no spiritual encounter, there will be no change,
no change
or access to the kingdom of God.
Amen.
You see, Jesus is still saying, contrary to, I don't care who's preaching it, but Jesus is still saying, I am the way,
yes,
the truth, and the life.
Yes.
No man comes to the Father except through me. We, the church, God's called out was the ecclesia, must go out and tell this world about Jesus, who is the Christ.
Amen.
Understand, church, change does not require acceptance, but acceptance. Does require change. If this world accepts the living water of Jesus that Jesus has to offer, I'm telling you, it will change.
It will.
It will change.
Yes.
On the other hand, we the church don't want the world to say to us, like the woman said to Jesus in Jacob's well.
Help us.
You Christians don't have nothing to do with Samaritans. Can I make it plain? What you doing out here on this corner, preacher? You ain't got nothing to do with us.
That's right.
Well, that spirit will speak to him. How do you know? Because I dealt with those spirits in the street, man.
That's right.
You know, I dealt with them, and I rebuked that spirit in the name of Jesus.
Because I come
to do spiritual. I ain't come to argue with no flesh.
That's right.
We got to get to the point that we deal with that spirit operating behind the flesh.
Amen.
That's the real battle. We too busy arguing with people. We too busy afraid of people.
Well,
or maybe we're afraid, we saved enough to be afraid of that spirit.
Jesus.
All I know,
Jesus
I know, they might want to know, who are you? You got to have some boldness. I had a guy walk up on me nose to nose babbling in Baltimore. I was like, oh my God. He was a babbler in the streets. He was a babbler. Walk around crazy. I just started praying, started speaking to that spirit.
That's right.
Release him.
Yes.
He's a child of God.
Jesus.
He don't belong to you. And all of a sudden, I seen some clarity in his eyes begin to clear up. He came to his right mind, kissed me on the cheek, and went away.
My Lord.
Was I scared? You better know it, because he's known for being a crazy man in the streets battling. How do you know, preacher? I had a local preacher down there, and he decided, I want to go ahead and do what pastor did.
Yeah, yeah. My Lord.
My Lord. Better watch out.
Amen.
Amen.
You better watch out.
That's right.
He went out there, and that man ran him in the church with his tail tucked between his ladies, and I ain't never going back in the street.
That's right. That's right.
You got to be ready for spiritual warfare. You got to be ready because those spirits will run up on you.
Yeah.
Now, when I was in the street, if you ran up on me,
woo,
if my ride or die wasn't there, see, I traveled with a set of four brothers. We was known as the 45. Not because we carried them, because that's what we drank. And they said, this boy's a crazy drinking that Coke 45. You ain't never seen none of us alone. It was always two or more. When you run up on one of them, you had some trouble on your hands. And it's
the same thing when you run up on a child of God.
Yes.
When the greater one lives in you.
Yes.
When that spirit pushes up on you. You better say, you better take another look.
Yes.
You better, do you recognize who you step into?
Yes.
And if you don't see me, if you only see me, you better look behind me and see my
heart.
I got the Father. I got the Son. Into the street,
yes,
when you go on your job,
yes,
when you go in that grocery store,
yes,
you got to be like that.
That's right, brother. That's right.
Because that spirit will step to you.
Yes.
You call yourself a child of God.
My Lord, my Lord.
Didn't God ask the devil, did you consider my servant?
Yes, my
Lord.
You don't know if you was considered.
Well,
that's right.
Jesus.
That's right.
Come on.
That's right.
See, now, you don't know if God gave him permission to roll up on you.
That's right.
You better be right.
Amen.
Jesus.
You better be right. When we deal with Samaritans or non-saved folk, don't let them say you don't have no dealing with God.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Help us, Holy Ghost. See, Jesus is the catalyst for all spiritual change. Jesus said to the woman, if you knew the gift of God and who it is who says to you, give me a drink, you would have asked him and he would have given you living water.
Living water.
This world is thirsty, but it's drinking the wrong water. It's drinking from the well of Jacob, a stagnant well where the water is still. You see, living water is moving, it stays much fresher, cleaner than stagnant water. Jesus says to the woman, whoever drinks of this water, the living water of Jacob's well, will thirst again. But whoever drinks of the water I shall give him will never thirst. But the water I shall give him will become in him a fountain of water springing up to everlasting life.
Amen.
It's time for us to flood these streets.
Yeah.
It's flood the United States with living water.
Yeah.
It shall be springing up out of us so much so that every demon in hell should have a canoe or a rough boat. Hell, in order they're going to get drowned.
That's right.
By the living water. Springing up.
That's right.
Out of the ecclesia. Understand that Jesus sees the lost in this world differently than us.
Amen.
When he saw this woman, he didn't see her as the rest of Samaria saw her. Jesus sees people in a way that we do not.
That's right.
See, we see a panhandler begging for money.
Well,
and make like we busy in the car doing something like we don't see him. But Jesus sees the lost sheep in need of living water.
Yes,
we
see
a homeless person and we say, oh, he should know better, she should know better.
Well,
but Jesus sees one of his lost sheep in need of some living water.
Yes.
We see a drug addict and an alcoholic. Jesus sees one of his lost sheep in need of some living water.
Okay.
I don't know about the rest of you, but I'm so glad that when Jesus saw me, he saw one of his lost sheep in need of some living water. And not just another drug dealer and alcoholic. I'm so glad that he reached down into the muck in the mind and picked me up. You don't know part of my testimony. The day I got saved, out in my car was a cool ice day. And it wasn't with Coke and Pepsi. They didn't know that in the glove compartment was a piece of Coke like that. But God got a hold of me. God said, you don't need none of that. Take a sip of this. You don't need Coke 45. You don't need easy Jesus, what we priest to call it in, Jack. You don't need none of that. Take a drink from my living water, and you will never thirst again. The only thing I'm thirsty about now is more Jesus.
More Jesus.
Oftentimes, our opinions of others are completely based on what we see on the outside.
Help us.
Jesus had a way of looking into a person's heart and seeing what they need and what they can really do. Jesus saw this woman not as a woman who had five husbands and as we say today, shacking it with another man.
Amen.
Jesus saw her as an evangelist who would go tell the town about him and invite them to come. See a man.
Amen.
Woo! Who told me all about myself. Come! See a man. Woo! Read through that fourth chapter. You'll find out that at the end, the men testified to her. They said, now that we've heard him, now that we went and saw him, we believe because of what he said and not because you told us to go see.
Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Invite the world to come see a man.
The world.
And watch it change. This world is thirsty for living water.
Yes, it is.
You must invite them to come see. Amen.
Amen.
All right.
As I close, allow me to paint a picture. The Gospel of John depicts Jesus as living water. An image that the Samaritan woman missed, and honestly, so does the world today.
Amen. Mm.
We understand now because we say sanctified, filled with the Holy Ghost, and they got a little education biblically.
Yeah.
We know Jesus talking about spiritual things, not physical ones, as the Samaritan woman thought. But we miss out on the real picture.
Real picture. Mm-hmm.
Look back through the Gospel of John and see his use of water. You see, in John chapter 1, water is used with the baptism of John for repentance, and repentance being required as entrance into the kingdom of God.
Well,
chapter 2, water from purification jugs was turned into wine as a sign of the coming of the kingdom of God that Jesus was bringing. Chapter 3, Nicodemus creeped around at night. We know how you creep around at night. He didn't want the church to see him. He creeped around at night. And Jesus told him that you must be born again of water and of the Holy Spirit. So now here we are. In chapter 4, Jesus offers himself as living water to the Samaritan woman. She does not understand what he's offering, but what Jesus offered her, he's offering to us and all the world today.
Amen.
Jesus is the living water. Jesus is the source of eternal life. Jesus said to Martha, I am the resurrection. And the life. He who believes in me, though he may die, he shall live.
Whoever lives
and believes in me shall never die. I like it because behind that period, he asked a question.
Yeah.
He said, Martha, do you believe this? Do you believe what I'm saying to you? When you take of the living water Jesus gives, you will never need to drink again.
Amen. Amen.
This is not a literal statement, but an image of eternity. Jesus brings eternal life which you will have no need and no want for.
Amen.
Oh, to see your face to face.
When
I get that brand new body, when I'm clothed in my white robe.
Yes.
I know my mom, my daddy, my grandparents, and all. Yeah. And I got some friends and family over there. Yeah. But I'm looking to see Jesus.
Yeah.
I'm looking to see him face to face. And we sing a song in the church that, oh, when I see Jesus, can tell him all about my trouble. Don't you know when you see Jesus, the only trouble you got, it depends on what seat you're standing in.
All right. All right.
Well, yeah. Well,
all right. You better be standing before the right throne.
Amen.
Well, you certainly got some trouble to talk about.
Amen.
That's right.
Well, you certainly got, but I ain't got no more trouble.
No. Amen.
When I see Jesus.
No.
Amen. Mm-mm. Amen. Mm-mm. The fulfillment Jesus gives is completely satisfying.
Amen.
You need nothing but Jesus.
Nothing but Jesus. Mm-hmm.
This world needs nothing but Jesus.
Amen. Amen, preacher.
He brings a gift. A drink
yes.
that if it takes it, this world would never thirst.
Never thirst again.
Amen.
Praise God.
Amen.
Whew.
All right.
We know something about being thirsty physically, but we need to be spiritually thirsty.
Amen.
We can't be satisfied with just getting saved.
Amen.
But salvation is the first step.
Mm-hmm.
Let us stand. If there is one under the sound of my voice who is thirsty, who want that thirst quenched, I stand before you today and offer you the one who can quench your thirst. His name is Jesus the Christ. If you don't know Jesus for the pardon of your sins, you can come this morning, this afternoon, this evening, whatever time of day it is. Give your hand to the preacher, but give your heart to God. And I'm going to make it easy. You ain't even got to come. You can raise your hand. And either I or another minister of the gospel will go to you and lead you to Christ. You know his word is true. And his word said if you confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus Christ and believe in your heart that God had raised him from the dead, you shall be saved. You shall be saved. I'm not going to belabor the point. See, I like to say this in my church. Everybody in here say,
amen.
Everybody say,
amen.
How come you ain't shout?
Amen.
I thank God I'm saved.
Amen.
I thank God I'm saved. Everybody saved. Anybody stand in the need of prayer, special need of prayer? Come on. Or if you want to come, or just raise your hand. Everybody stand in special need of prayer. Everybody need prayer. If you don't need it, somebody please pray for me.
Yes.
Have me on your mind. Take the time and pray for me.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. All hearts and minds clear. Father God, you know all and you see all. You saw the ones who stand in the need of special prayer, Father God. And Father God, you said if we ask anything, Jesus said, if we ask anything in his name, and if it's according to your will, Father God, we know that need that these individuals have shall be met.
Yes.
Father God, cover them. Cover them right now from the crown of their head to the soles of their feet. Bless them in any way that they may need to be blessed, Father God. Now, Father God, I ask you to continue to bless this man of God here.
Yes,
Lord Jesus. Yes.
Keep this church, Lord.
Yes,
keep
God.
St. Luke, Father God, and every member on the roll.
Yes.
Father God, your word says you have not given us a spirit of fear, but a power, love, and a sound mind, Father God. The universal church, Father God.
Yes.
The universal church. I pray for them.
Yes.
For the universal church.
Yes.
Because some of your children are fearful of COVID. And everything else that the streets may have to offer. But Lord, we know that your word is true. And Psalms 91 promises us that no plague should come nigh to our dwelling.
Yes. Yes.
So we're going to stand on your word, Lord. Cover them. Help those of us who are strong, help bear the infirmities of the weak.
Yes.
Help us keep them lifted up before you, Lord.
Yes.
And in your time, they shall step out on faith.
Yes.
Step out on faith, Father God. We want to be a blessing to the kingdom of God.
Yes.
So use every individual ministry, every individual that's here today,
yes,
to be such a blessing,
yes,
to you and your kingdom.
Yes.
Continue to watch over us, Father God, those who may have to travel.
Yes.
Grant us traveling mercy.
Yes.
Father God, continue to bless the UAME church.
Yes. Yes.
Keep it as only you can.
Yes.
Bless our leaders, Lord.
Yes.
Bless our bishops.
Yes.
Bless them, Lord God. Strengthen them, Father God,
yes,
on every leaning side.
Yes.
Keep a hedge of protection not only around them, but their families, yes, Lord God, so they can keep their hand firmly planted in yours and their eyes fixed on you.
Yes, Lord.
Father God, help us unionize, Father God, not be afraid to change.
Mm.
Not be afraid to do what thus says the Lord.
Yes.
Help us to step out on faith and begin to speak to mountains.
Yes. Mm.
With the faith the size of a mustard.
Yes. Mm.
And we'll continue to give you all the glory, all the honor, and all the praise.
Yes.
In Jesus' name, amen.
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 Praise God. I said this in my church, and those who know what I'm talking about, so you can follow along with me. Praise God, church.
Praise God.
Room all blessings flow. Praise Him, all creatures here below. Praise Him above the heavenly host.
Somebody a sip of water. I preached over in the second district. Take a sip of this. I'm talking about that new wine there.
Mm-hmm.
But they need to take a sip of the living water.
Mm-hmm.
And they will never thirst again.
Mm-hmm.
Now unto him who is able to keep you from falling and present you faultless before his throne with exceeding joy, to the only wise God our Savior be glory, majesty, dominion, and power now and henceforth and forevermore. And all of God's children said,
Amen. Amen. Amen.
God bless you. I love you.
God bless you.
Love you.
God bless you.
Amen.
God bless you. God bless you.